Hello, everyone. So we have got a treat for you. We have got the wonderful Emma Darcy, and she's going to show you how to choose your own adventure. There's possibly some cats involved and a harp. Stay tuned. Hey, everyone. Welcome to Less Code, More Power. I'm Sarah, and I'm joined by my co-host, Donna.
Hello.
And we are joined by our amazing guest, Emma Darcy. And you may see a few cats as well. So, Emma, we are so stoked to have you on the show today. Like, really, you've got an amazing story in terms of how you really, you know, have been working with the Dynamics platform and all of that. And then, you know, how you're getting more and more into the Power Platform now as well. And you've got this, I really want to talk about the Dunder Mifflin show. I've got so many things that we can chat about. But before we do, please go ahead and can you just like share with the audience, like kind of who you are, your passions, you know, what's important for you, what's going on for you right now?
Yeah, sure thing. So I'm Emma Darcy. Firstly, thanks so much for having me, guys. I'm really stoked to be here with two of my absolute favorite people. This is really exciting. I've been in the Dynamics space for almost 10 years now, and that makes me feel so old. It's crazy. But mostly been active in the community aspect for probably the last year or so. And how I actually got introduced to the Dynamics community is really, really fun. I had a half of a degree in IT, and then I ran out of money and never actually finished my degree, which I think is actually kind of fun. And so at the time, I really needed a job. So I was like, I'll just apply for anything and see what happens. And this job for application specialist came up. And I was not qualified in any shape or form. I was like, oh, look, I'll just give it a go and see what happens. And so I applied for it, went for the interview, and it went really well. And they gave me like this logic test to do. And they literally said, this is not a trick quiz. Just see how you get on. Just go through the flow. See how you do. So I went through the logic flow. And I was like, the answer is 42. And they were like, yes. This is amazing. You passed. This is brilliant. And on your resume or your CV in Ireland, a lot of people tend to put their hobbies down. And one of my hobbies is playing a lot of video games. So at the end of the interview, the person interviewing me was like, so you play video games? Yeah. How many times have you prestiged on Call of Duty? I was like, twice. And he was like, wow, that's amazing. And we talked a little bit about, you know, changing DNS settings on our Xboxes. And that actually got me the job. They were like, you know what a DNS is? I was like, yeah. So they gave me the job on the spot. And I started working with Dynamics AX. So working with AX4 originally, which is kind of interesting, working with a lot of accountants and inventory. And as I got acquainted with AX, they started to ask me to look at using, it was called Dynamics Customer Engagement, not Customer Engagement, 365 CRM. It's had like 17 names.
It has had so many names.
And so they asked me to implement a service desk using CRM. And I basically gave it a go. I did a customization configuration course and absolutely loved it. And that was 9 years ago. And here I am still plugging away in the L customer engagement world.
That is amazing.
This is such a good lesson. And do not be gated by your degree or lack of degree or what you studied. Because humans hire humans, right? That's who they hire. It's who you resonate with, who you feel like can do the job. And I'm such a big fan of people who've made their own path in the world just based on their own interests and skills, mm-hmm. rather than I have these qualifications or I come from this level of nepotism family, or, you know, I've had these kinds of accreditations. It's mm-hmm. you've made your own way in the world through your love of video games. And
yeah, honestly,
just chasing your curiosities and saying, I think I can figure this out. And then that level of confidence makes your employer feel like, yeah, I think she can figure it out. And exactly. I don't know what that Call of Duty level prestige thing even is. So I would be like, yay, that sounds complex and hard. So that's awesome.
Just shows that I'm very dedicated to something I'm passionate about. That's what it shows.
Exactly. And has high hand-eye coordination, which
exactly.
I do not have. So I appreciate that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So cool. So tell us, what are you doing now? What are you working on?
So I work for an ISV called Click Dimensions. They're a marketing solution for the Dynamics 365 platform. And I am a senior product consultant there. No, not product consultant. I was a product consultant. I'm a pre-sales engineer there. I get that confused all the time. But I've been at Click for about 3.5 years now, and I'm super passionate about what I do. They basically let me have free range across the entire Power Platform and let me to build things to help extend our product and help assist our customers. So that's what I'm doing at the moment.
That's awesome. Amazing. Can you tell us about that harp in the background? Is that harp?
It is a harp, yes. So obviously I'm very Irish, and my sister, I live with my sister here in Philadelphia, and she actually plays multiple instruments, and this harp just tends to be in the background of all of my meetings, and I don't play harp, but people are like, do you play harp?
I love that. I love that you're almost using it as a prop for your meeting.
It is.
See my harp. Is that yours?
I am extra Irish.
Like, oh, this is amazing. Philly, but I'm actually Irish. We're like, exactly. We know. That is so cool.
I love that you, you know, I love that you've, you know, you've done a few roles in Quick Dimensions, but in terms of the, you know, especially being around for the kind of eight to 10 years, you've seen the platform change like considerably. Like you're looking at CRM 2011 days to then what is now the Power Platform, and obviously then Dynamics 365 being a first party app. How has that influenced your path? Because I definitely resonate with what Donna said in terms of, I love that you were just like, screw it, I'm just gonna, I haven't got all the things that I need for this job or whatever, I'm just gonna go for it. But also the platform's changed so much, and a lot of people struggle with that. A lot of people struggle with the change. Even in the technology industry, it changes all the time and we know it, but when we're on the wrong side of change, it can be really bad. How has that impacted you in your career at Click Dimensions?
It's really expanded my horizons. So back in the day, you know, I was only working with Dynamics Customer Engagement because everything was so isolated and so siloed. And now with the introduction of the Power Platform and the Common Data Service and Power Automate and Power Virtual Agents and Power BI, the list goes on and on. I'm now able to bring in data from different aspects and actually put it all together and marry it and make some beautiful applications for my clients. So things that I couldn't solve even a year ago, 2 years ago, I'm now able to do with simply putting together a Power Automate that might take me 30 minutes. And if it can make somebody's life that much easier or make a task just happen that much faster, it's just fantastic. Time is probably our most precious commodity in life, and being able to give that back to some people is just amazing.
Wow. I love that
line. That's such a good line, where it's, you are not helping customers with tech, you're helping them reclaim time. Mm-hmm. And it's the thing you can never buy more of. So
exactly.
Such a powerful statement. I love that. So you've got a choose your own adventure situation that you brought.
Yes, yeah. I do. This is something that I'm actually really excited about. So myself and a good colleague of mine, Mary Thompson, came together and we were working on Power Virtual Agents together. And she is out in South Carolina and has a child. And because we were all kind of in lockdown at the moment, we were thinking, what can we do to try and, you know, help him get through the day, help him with his education, all that kind of thing. And we came up with the idea of building a choose your own adventure story, completely using the Power Virtual Agent. And when you use Power Virtual Agent, everyone's going to see the functionality as more of, you know, a shop assistant or a help bot or something like that. But the fact that you're able to pick different paths and branch off paths and use conditional logic and store variables and return images, all that kind of thing, really made me think that it could be used as more of a choose your own adventure type tool. And of course, being a gamer, I really enjoy the aspect of being able to, what happens if I click on this button? What happens if I insert this piece of text? That kind of thing. So we put together a prototype of a choose your own adventure that we are currently working on.
What? Can't wait to see this. Let's see this. Show us the demo. Show us what you've built.
Sure. So the way we kick off this adventure is we basically just started off with a standard greeting or a standard trigger phrase. So I'm just going to say hello to the bot. And the bot's going to respond and be like, hey, are you up for an adventure? But it's firstly going to ask you for your name. So this is kind of an example of where we're taking an input from the end user and we're going to use it throughout our actual story. So I'm going to put in Emma. And it's going to say, hey, it's lovely to meet you. Let's get started. And this particular story is because our days are so not normal, they're not in their traditional routines. We kind of wanted to simulate what it would be like as an 8-year-old or a 9-year-old in regular life. And so in this case, you're being told that you can hear your alarm clock, but your decision here is going to determine whether or not you're going to get breakfast. So in my case, if I click get up immediately, it's going to tell me, you know, I'm smashing the alarm button and now I actually get to choose breakfast because I got up immediately instead of waiting later on, which means that I wouldn't be able to get breakfast. So in my case, I'm Irish. I don't understand the obsession with waffles, so I'm definitely going to take cereal. And to bring in a bit of an educational aspect to this as well, we decided to incorporate some standard kind of virtual homework. A lot of kids were studying from home, that kind of thing. And so if we take a look at these different selections that we have math or ELA. And if I pick the math option, it's going to be like, math is super fun, but it's also going to return this really cool image that allows the child to actually click and enlarge to actually take a look at their mathematical homework that they can then go ahead and complete. So that was done using Power Automate just to pull out an image from Azure Blob, which is really, really simple, but really effective. And once we've completed our math homework, we then have the decision to say, do we want to do more? If you're a bit of an overachiever, or if you're like me and you want to slack off a bit, we can pick the no more homework option. Mm-hmm. And once the homework is done, this is kind of where the adventure gets started. You can decide, do you want to stay indoors or do you want to go outdoors? And in my example here, I'm probably going to pick the outdoor because we've been cooped up for so long. I want to get outside for a bit. And it's going to say, do you want to go to your friend's house? Do you want to go to a pond? Our plan is to eventually add even more options to this tool, but we've kept it pretty simple for now to flesh out the proof of concept. So if we go to our friend's house, there's actually a really nice little bit of conditional logic in here that decides, did you get up on time to have breakfast? If you had breakfast, tell your friend, what did you have for breakfast, and display that back. So it's a nice little bit of just taking those variables in. And if we decide to play some Xbox, it'll then kind of move on to that other topic, which actually kind of relates into the indoor activities too. And it allows us to then decide what kind of games do we want to play on Xbox. If we pick the Forza option, we can either race with our friends or work on our car. If we work on our car, it actually kind of displays us back the different things that we worked on our car that day. And then when we get to the end of the adventure, it's really cool because it will be like, what did you do today? And you get to tell your mom exactly what you did for the entire day and relay the whole entire adventure by starting it again or just completing it here by clicking on the end. And we intend on going a lot further with this by implementing methods of gathering all the different variables that you've selected, and at the end, being able to build out this entire adventure story in a Word document that the child can then print out and kind of go to their parent and be like, hey, look at this really cool adventure that I built, or this really cool adventure that I went on. It was all digital and all indoors. So yeah, that's a very short example of the choose your own adventure bot that we're currently working on.
This is so cool. I love this. I mean, like, kind of especially from a kid's perspective, the fact that they can go, my favorite part was the whole, I love homework, right? I'm a bit weird like that, I guess. I would have definitely picked, by the way, the other homework, the extra homework. But I love that you're using Azure Blob and bringing that in, like from an extensibility perspective. Like, you can actually really structure this and bring even more homework in, like, as in, I love that you're kind of making it fun, but you're actually kind of making it educational as well without them really knowing it.
Yeah. There's just so many different possibilities for this tool. So this is like just one very simple example. And our plan going forward is actually to reach out to a lot more children and actually teach them how to build their own bots. So there's a lot of work going around with power apps and teaching kids how to build their own power apps. But teaching a child how to build a PVA or a power virtual agent and getting them to be creative and build their own story is something I'm really excited about.
What I love about that is, first of all, that is the most fun PVA I've ever seen. And I've seen maybe like 2000 PVAs, but by far the most fun most fun PVA award goes to you and Mary. But second, kids will love to build their own because they have built-in interaction right there. It's not like, oh, go find someone to use my app. It's, I can just talk to this machine and have so much fun with it and have this bot sound as funny or as ridiculous as I want it to be.
Yes.
That is fantastic. I love
that. I'm working on a more adult version where it will allow you to pick your own, pick it. It's going to recommend a type of beer to you depending on your flavors and choices. So I actually, because I really like very specific kinds of beers. So it's the random cocktail. So, you know, PVA can be used like, do you like light? Do you like malty? Do you like sweet? And being able to then, like, here is a selection of beers you could try. And we can implement that even in a business scenario. If you're like a wine and beer store, for example, it'd be a really great way of recommending products to people.
That is the most Irish software engineer solution.
It's kind of nice. I love that. Like a lot of people are doing like Friday evening kind of sessions as well. Like with, like from an employee perspective, it's like kind of a networking session and trying to get, you know, from a kind of human perspective, trying to get to know their colleagues and stuff like that, especially from a mental health perspective and all that kind of stuff. And this again could be used in that scenario as well. That's
definitely.
So
So we never let our guests go without assigning homework to our lovely viewers. So what you got?
So for me this week, I have had a couple of things on my mind since we've all been in this quarantine position right now. I think, and you actually kind of led into this really nicely, Sarah, mental health is such an important thing. There's been a lot going on in the world around us lately. And my homework for everyone is to check in with your friends, check in with your community members, and just make sure they're doing okay. For me personally this week, I've actually had quite a lot of anxiety and I've been quite overwhelmed, but I've had people check in with me, go through things with me one by one, and just really help me reset and get back in that same mindset. So that's my homework, is to check in with your friends, check in with your family members, check in with your communities, your colleagues, just make sure everyone's doing okay, because you won't actually realize how much of an impact that can have on someone until you just reach out and say, hey, it's really nice.
There's a great PVA idea right there. Make a PVA to check in with people and send the link to a bunch of people in your life. And just keep an eye on what your people are saying, because you can track analytics in the back. And often it's easier for a person to tell a bot that they're not okay than to tell a person.
Exactly.
I think that would be amazing. Take Emma's homework, take Emma's what Emma's done, and choose your mental health status or state. That would be amazing. Awesome. Thank you so much, Emma, for being here with us today. And lovely viewers, if you haven't tried Par Virtual Agent, oh my God, you're not listening to us.
Like, where have you been?
Come on. You're like the last person on the planet now who's never tried PVAs. 8-year-old kids are building PVAs. You need to build your first PVA. So definitely go to Par Virtual Agent, look it up. It auto-generates a bot for you, and you just start modifying your existing one. Thank you so much, Emma, for being here with us.
You're so welcome.
Thank you. Till next time, less code,
more power.